Then I'm going to look at the second part of the expression that will deal with the human respiratory system. Now, in the human respiratory system, in fact, in the human, we have got the three different respiratory systems. One is asking through which human being excrete excess of water and salts. Especially in the summer season, when a lot of perspiration takes place. Basically, that is the excretion of the water and the dissolved salts through a skin, which not only removes excess of water and the salt from the body, but also provides a cooling effect during the summer season. The second respiratory system, that is liver. In the liver, the red blood cells, which have completed their work, they have matured enough. Now they disintegrate into the liver and gives away bilirubin, being collected in gallbladder. And from the gallbladder, through the alimentary canal, this is being excreted out along with the excess of the food and undigested food. Now, the major part what we are going to discuss, that is the important excretory part, that is the kidneys in the form of urine. So, as in the first part I discussed about what are the different excretory products, like the metabolites. Out of that, the major part of the urine is, that is urea, that is being excreted out through the human respiratory system, which is, I'm going to explain it, what are there and how does it work. So basically, the two kidneys are located in the this part of the body, and these pair of kidneys are having the blood supplies to the various blood vessels like arteries and the vein as well. But the basic thing, that is for the removal of the unwanted substances from the body, that is being carried out into the kidneys, and from the kidneys, these excretory materials they come out through a pair of ureters. So there is a pair of ureters which open up in the urinary bladder over here, and in the urinary bladder when it gets filled up, that urine is removed from the body through urethra. So the human respiratory system consists of a pair of kidneys like these two. Then these are the ureters. They are the urinary bladder, and this one is urethra. So these are the composition of the urinary system, which is supplied with the blood vessels. This is, you must be knowing that this is the vena cava, and this is aorta. So here, oxygenated oxygen blood has got no meaning. In fact, that both contain respiratory substances. The only difference is these two, the blood supply to these vessels, that is the oxygen and the deoxygenated blood. But both types of blood are being carried out into the kidneys, where they get filtered out, and after filtration, the respiratory materials along with the water that comes out into the urinary bladder through the ureters, and they are then removed from the body through urethra. Now, what happens into the kidneys? The pair of kidneys, they consist of kidneys consist of millions of filtration units called nephrons. These nephrons are the basically the structural and functional units of kidneys. So the basic filtration is being carried out into the millions of nephrons, and those filtrate, they are collected into the collecting tubule, which open up into the ureter, and through the ureter they are being collected over here. Now, regarding nephrons, its a structure, how does it work, we will discuss in our the next part of this lesson, that is the season. But right now, I would like to give you certain informations regarding the filtration into the kidneys. That is, the two kidneys, they work 24 hours without a stoppage, and into the nephrons, there is filtration of blood under pressure, and that is for ultra filtration. The filtration of blood under pressure, that is known as the ultra filtration, where that is apart from blood corpuscles, that is water minerals, dissolved urea, hormones and essential materials like glucose, they also get filtered out over here. In fact, the total filtrage throughout the day in the 24 hours that is obtained from the kidneys is nearly 20 liters. The filtrate is 20 liters, but ultimately the urine is 1.5 liters as per experimental method. So 20 liters are the filtrate and 1.5 liters is the urine. Now, what about 18.5 liters of the filtrate? So, what happens after the ultrafiltration? The whole substances will pass through the tubules of the nephrons, where there is the reabsorption of the essential substances, the excess of water, and the minerals like calcium. They are being reabsorbed. So thereby, the total output of the urine that becomes lesser than 1.5 liters. Now the amount of urine that is being passed away by a normal human being, that is 1.5 liter a day. However, in the summer season, you must have observed that less urination. This is because of the fact a large amount of water is being removed from the body through the skin in the form of sweat. So, if all the water is coming out from the body, naturally our body will get dehydrated. So, the body requires the required amount of water. So, that's why when there is ultrafiltration, the water what is needed by the body that is being reabsorbed and the amount of urine that decreases. So basically the amount of urine being discharged by a normal human being, although it should be 1.5 liters, but in the summer season it becomes lesser. That's why this is recommended that we must consume more and more water so that all the hot water materials accumulated into our body that is being removed. So water is another important part. So in the output of urine, the questions are being asked, that is the what decides the output of urine. The output of urine is being decided by the amount of water, excess amount of water rather into the body. Apart from the mineral substances which are not needed by our body. So these two factors, that is the acidity materials and the water, these together decide the amount of urine being discharged by a human being in a normal course. So I hope I am clear about this urinary system, which also we have written over here as the respiratory system of the human. But respiratory system consists of not only this urinary system but also the skin and the liver as well. But we are more concerned about this urinary system, and in the next class I shall be discussing about the structural functional unit of the kidneys, that is nephrons, and thereafter we will talk about some certain other aspects associated with kidneys. So thank you for today.